Hi there, it's Jim Eskeman with another little quick tip on how to do impressions. I'm doing the impression of a cactus right now because I'm shooting an episode of The Soul Man with Cedric the Entertainer. Anyway, with that all that aside, I wanted to share with you another tip. We'll see if it's helpful. I hope so. But one thing I realized that I do and that I've always done and that a lot of my contemporaries definitely do is to imitate people kind of habitually, and whether that means performing it or not, but to listen to people and the people around me. And I realize it all started back when I was a kid, and I would imitate my first babysitter that I remember, whose name was Connie Godby here, and she, I think, was from the north of England somewhere, because she sounded just like Mrs. Doubtfire. That's when I was a wee bairn. And teachers, of course, you know, I wasn't a class clown, but I could do and whip out impressions of my teachers, particularly, you know, after my voice changed. People like my graphic arts teacher, Mr. Fackler. Mr. Fackler had a particular way of talking, and I always thought it was because he had a long beard and a mustache that maybe it was hanging up his mouth, but now I realize that's probably anatomically impossible. And I would do a Mr. Macias, the other shop teacher, who was obviously, you know, from Mexico probably, or his family was at least. He was a very kind of, you know, patient, but at the same time very sour person. And I remember Mr. Larson, the PE teacher. He used to talk a little bit like this. And Ed Gunny, there was a guy named Ed Gunny, too. How you have to screw up your whole face to talk like Ed Gunny. He didn't look like this, but this is what he sounded like. My great-grandmother was from West Texas, and she used to say, I knew her, she was like, you know, 100 years old, literally, and she would say things like,
well, I wish you'd look.
And so I'm a collector, you know, and obviously a lot of us actors are collectors of personalities and interesting characters so that we can change them, we can make them into something else, or we can drag them out when they're necessary. You read a script and it says, you know, old woman from Texas who looks like she's 100 years old.
I know exactly what she should sound like.
And it's a kind of an ongoing thing. It's like, it would be as if I'm the kind of guy who collects action figures, you know, and goes to swap meets and goes to trade shows and, I don't know, talks about this stuff. I'm currently just bewitched by Dame Edna, who I saw live. If you've never seen the great Barry Humphreys do his character Dame Edna, it's just a superb imaginative creation. I don't know, he's imitating a typical Melbourne housewife of 1950, but now it's, you know, 2015, and he continues to tour around and do it. I think this is his, he says it's his farewell tour. If you have a chance to see Barry Humphreys, Dame Edna, live, do not miss it. It is, I can't recommend it enough. In the meantime, you can see all kinds of stuff on YouTube. Check out his Les Patterson. Les Patterson is an Australian. He's an Australian piece of work. Anyway, you got to check him out. His characters are just amazing. And so this is what we do. So if you are the kind of person who is inclined to collect personalities, to listen to voices, to go, well, you know, I'd like to do that accent. Or, gee, I know this guy at work and he talks like this all the time. I wonder, can I do that? You know, go ahead and indulge that because it's actually time well spent. Not only might you be able to use that character for something or combine it with another voice to create a new character, a hybrid, but also it just exercises and gives you familiarity with your own musical instrument. It's like you're jamming. You're trying to see, you know, what are the limits of this thing?
How high can I go? How high?
And how low can I go?
If I push something over here, you know, like some people talk like this, can I do it? How long could I do it? Could I do it for 45 minutes or an hour? Who knows?
You won't know until you goof around with it and play and see what your limitations are. Maybe you're the only person who has no limitations. Wouldn't that be nice? Then you'd be kind of like that guy in The Matrix. Ooh. Anyway, I hope some of that is helpful to you. Anyway, it gives me a chance to put myself in front of you and say hello. And hey, stay tuned for good news about The Impression Guys. If you haven't seen The Impression Guys yet, please watch it on YouTube now. That's the place to watch it. Who knows, maybe you'll be able to watch it somewhere else soon. But for now, watch it there on the Soul Pancake channel. Thanks for watching. Subscribe, comment, do all those things that we do in this crazy, crazy social media age. And you know, I love you, each and every one of you. So please, leave me a nice message. Oh, for a minute I thought this was my phone machine. It's not. Okay, I'll talk to you guys real soon.
Adios.